Thank you for the introduction. Hello, everybody. I welcome those students from Russia, United States, and also various cities of Japan. Today, I'm going to talk about the 70 years of the nuclear age, atomic bombs, and the history of human science. I have been an atomic bomb disease researcher for over 40 years. Based on my long experience, I will introduce human consequences of atomic bombing too. Maybe you have already read or learned about the history of Nagasaki. The first part of my talk is about history of Nagasaki city. It is somehow related to why Nagasaki city was chosen for the second target of the atomic bombing. Nagasaki port was opened in 1541 to European countries such as Portugal and Spain. And in 18th century, Nagasaki was very, very prosperous because of the international trade between Dutch, Holland, and China, and sometime Korea. In the end, after 1850, in 1852, first Western-style hospital in Japan, name is Yojosho. This is the first hospital in Japan was established. This is my alma mater. So my school is 160 years old this year. So that Dr. Pompey became the director of the hospital and taught many Japanese young doctors. And those doctors went back to their homes and spread Western medicine all over Japan. 1868 is an important year for Japanese history. This is called Meiji Revolution. It is not a real revolution, but a change of the political system. Nagasaki port is already full of Western ships, as you see here, and many foreigners were living. They were mostly merchants, sometimes engineers. They introduced shipbuilding companies and mine companies, etc. This was the beginning of the real Japanese modernization. But soon Japan entered the imperialism, international imperialism. Japan colonized Korea, Taiwan, after China-Japan War, 1895, and also Japanese War, 1904. This port is famous for the wintertime base for Vladivostok Navy, Russian Navy fleet. Every year, in winter time, they came to Nagasaki port, stay 2-3 months, because Vladivostok port is deeply frozen. But finally, Russian Empire and Japanese Empire fought. After the victory of the Russo-Japanese War, Japan got South Manchuria. Yeah. Then Japan invaded Manchuria, total Manchuria, and mainland China. That causes World War II. At that time, Nagasaki became a very, very huge military industrial city like this. In 1940, one of the world's largest battleships, Musashi, name is Musashi, built in Nagasaki. So this was the made the possibility to become a target of atomic bombing. I was born in June 5, 1943, in this Nagasaki. On August 9, 1945, I encountered the world's second atomic bomb detonation at 2.7 kilometers. Later, I show you the point. I was 2 months old, therefore no memory. This may be fortunate, maybe unfortunate to me. I studied hard to learn what the nuclear weapon is and how they were developed. Later, in 1968, I became a medical doctor and an atomic bomb disease researcher. I witnessed almost whole period of the 70 years of the nuclear age or era. As you know now very well about the consequence of two atomic bombs used in war, Hiroshima and Nagasaki, uranium bomb and the plutonium bomb. I just mentioned 1 kilogram of plutonium. This plutonium destroyed Nagasaki. 1 kilogram you can hold by your own hand, this size. This is the photographs before and after the bombing of Hiroshima. This picture was presented at the time of the second conference on the humanitarian impact of nuclear weapons held in Nayarit, Mexico, 2014. My title was talk was, if another 60 kiloton atomic bomb detonates on a modern city, a study based on Hiroshima Nagasaki cases. Later, in the end of this, my talk, I will show our simulation of the 60 kiloton bomb detonation on modernized Hiroshima. Hiroshima is now 1 million population. This is Nagasaki, just before atomic bombing. My house was located here, and the original target was this point. This is the center of the downtown Nagasaki, but the bomb actually floated to this point. So original target and actual target, about 1.5 kilometers. So if this is a actual target, maybe I was perished. A few days after bombing, the 70% of Nagasaki devastated. I could survive at this point. So further, those two slides shows my house. Here is my house. You see here is a big church, the second largest church in Nagasaki, and another angle from the airplane, US airplane, taking the Nagasaki port. There was no battleships anymore. Japan was defeated completely. So upper slide shows Hiroshima ruin, and down lower photo Nagasaki medical school. This is my alma mater. 900 students and professors died on this campus. Here is a point of Kasui High School. You're sitting here now. And Nagasaki is now, this area is complete, totally regenerated. At the time of bombing, Rakami area was totally destroyed. Kasui High School here, so you are sitting here. How the nuclear weapons were developed? There were scientists and nuclear weapon development in the United States. That project is called Manhattan Project. There were atomic bomb plans also in Japanese Imperial Army and Navy. Nazi Germany was ahead, but all failed. Only the United States succeeded because of its big science and giant industry. The discovery of radiation, Dr. Röntgen in 1895 is a German doctor, but he found X-ray, discovery of X-ray at the Würzburg University of Central Germany. So he was awarded first Nobel Prize in Physics. You know his name very well. Anyone who took chest X-ray. This was a photo I was visiting with our medical students to Dr. Röntgen's laboratory, where the old instruments are kept for demonstration. Beautiful chapter. So this revolutionized medical photography. So if you put your forearm in front of this vacuum tube, the X-ray is going out and your bones are well photographed. This is a revolution. The first natural radionuclide was isolated by Dr. Marie Curie in 1886. The second Nobel Prize was given to Dr. Curie. He was young, Polish, researcher working in Paris. But for a long time she was engaged in radium research. She was heavily flooded by gamma ray. And when she became age 60, she suffered from leukemia related disease, MDS. This is a blood cell malignancy. She was probably the first victim of radiation. So later, four radiation species was found. Alpha ray, beta ray, gamma ray, and his X-rays, and neutron. Gamma ray and X-ray is almost similar. So this is a model of structure of atom. Atom is composed of neutron, proton, and if a neutron comes near to atom and hit the nucleus, the center of the atom, this nucleus break down. This is called fission. Fission division. Some create huge energy. This was Einstein's relativity theory equation. Okay? So this discovery meant we human beings can make another bomb, not TNT bomb, nuclear bomb. So that happened in late 1930s. So this year, World War II begins in 1939. Nuclear age starts, so 1940 actually. Dr. Einstein wrote a letter to US President Roosevelt asking for quicker development of nuclear weapons by the United States because Nazi researchers, physicists already started to make nuclear bomb. So Nobel Prize winners who escaped from Nazi Germany were working, many were working in the United States. Dr. Einstein, Dr. university, there was a very small world first nuclear power plant was established. And in this nuclear power plant, radium was processed to make plutonium. So Mr. Roosevelt, then the United States President, decided to start Manhattan Project, secret, very secret. That was 1940. And he named, appointed Dr. Oppenheimer for the chief of scientists. And this is Commander Leslie Groves, General Leslie Groves. These two guys promoted atomic bomb development at Los Alamos National Laboratory. This is New Mexico. And another harmful side, a nuclear power plant for isolation of plutonium, which was later used in Nagasaki bomb. This is located in Washington State. The first atomic bomb detonation in human history was observed at the Alamogordo Desert, New Mexico, July 16, 1945. I skipped the detailed mechanism of the atomic bomb detonation for the time scarcity. Dr. Oppenheimer observed this first detonation of his plutonium bomb, the same bomb as his Nagasaki bomb. He confessed, "I felt that I became god of death in Hindu religion." Soon the World War II end, and soon after this end of the war, Cold War started, as you know very well. And also hydrogen bomb was developed very soon. The largest bomb is 100 or 1,000 times powerful than Hiroshima-sized bomb. So many atmospheric testing were performed to develop those bombs. An American dentist found at this period increasing strontium, another nucleotide, concentration in the teeth of American children was rapidly enhanced or increased in 1960s. In Japan, atmospheric fallout continued during 1960s until partial disarmament treaty was established, mainly cesium and strontium. This is a cesium concentration of Japanese air in 1960s, 1970s. Very high, very high. This was my elementary school. We always wear baseball hat when rain starts. This is in body concentration of cesium in other people in Japan. This is very related. And the Japanese mushrooms at that time absorbed so many radionuclides. So, due to that dentist's report, United States President Mr. Kennedy established partial disarmament treaty with Soviet Union. That was 1963. After that, as you know very well, nuclear weapon number increased up to 70. 1,000. This is a peak of the nuclear weapon warheads. And now gradually decline, but still enough to destroy our earth. Now, I move on to human consequences. Maybe you observed those photographs already at the Atomic Bomb Museum, and the heat rays was so severe that people were deeply burned, like these girls. The skin totally and instantly destroyed, and skin break down into pieces. This was the most severe injury. In more shorter distance, people became carbonization, like charcoal, or burned to the bone. This lady is standing at her mother's side, mother and baby. These photos are taken one day after the bombing. The first day photographs, we have no first day photographs, unfortunately. Hiroshima, one photograph shows, was taken in the midst of the fire. In Nagasaki, such photos doesn't exist. So this is one day later. So you can recognize there was no rescue, medical rescue for those people, the heavily injured people. Maybe those are already dead. And the severe burn, this boy, maybe you looked at the photographs at the museum too, Mr. Taniguchi's back was totally, the skin, normal skin was all gone. And his under skin tissues are reddish tissue, naked. On this bedside, on this bed position, he spent almost 1.5 years to get back activity, daily activity. These are our hospital, but not real hospital. Elementary school, partially destroyed elementary school was used for ambulant hospitals. But there was no medical instrument, drugs, and even blood transfusion. So many hibakushas died within 3 months after bombing. This girl showing her total hair fall. This is a sign of a severe radiation exposure. Most of them died within 3 months. So this is the death curve, H Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The same curves was observed. This means the two atomic bombings were almost experimental nature. So those slides show acute radiation sickness, ARS, the major cause of early death. Air roots destruction, that cause hair loss. Bone marrow destruction, that caused severe anemia and low blood cell count and low blood platelet count. So bleeding occurs. These are called intestinal mucosa also damaged, and bleeding, a severe diarrhea starts. So dehydration ends. So those hibakushas died within 3 months. Severe skin burn caused during the healing process almost a cancer-like proliferation of skin. This is called keloid. But after 40 years, a long-term recovery phase, the skin became still, there is no normal skin. These are normal skin, but these are wolf's wound here. So after these 3 months, Hibakusha became quite healthy. So they began to work again. But within 3 years, rapid increase of leukemia, blood malignancy, took place both in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Those people who were exposed to radiation within 1.5 kilometers, the incidence of leukemia rapidly increased more than 50 times normal incidence is the dotted lines. Later, we found a clear dose, radiation dose response curve for the induction of excess leukemia cases like this. This is a formal proof, scientific proof, that atomic bomb radiation caused leukemia, blood cell malignancies. After declining of leukemia incidence, then people faced to the gradual increase of breast cancer, thyroid cancer, and many other types of cancers, sometimes multiple cancer in single patient. These red lines show many types of the cancer actually increased among short distance survivors. So this disease is almost leukemia-like disease, MDS, myelodysplastic syndrome, is now occurring among those Hibakushas who became elder over 70 years. This disease also dose-dependent in their instance. So in summary, surviving Hibakushas encountered fast peak of leukemia. It continued about 15 years. Then the gradual increase of solid tumors, that is cancers of thyroid, breast, lung, colon, stomach, and multiple cancers. So nowadays, the second leukemia peak is coming up when Hibakushas became elderly. Why such a long-term effect of radiation continue? Our researcher observed, for example, this is the chromosomes of blood cells, white blood cells, and red blood cells, the same damage to chromosome here, here, and here, here. So that means this patient's blood cells have all carried the same chromosome damage caused by radiation about 50 years ago. This was a study done after 50 years. Inside the Hibakusha's body, such cells are survivors with damage of chromosome caused by radiation. So what does this mean? Our cells consist of DNA, double strands. So the gamma ray, for example, split or cut the DNA, and this DNA damage will cause very strange abnormal genes. This is the one type of fusion genes which cause leukemia. Okay? If this radiation damage cause male sperm or female ova, this might be dangerous for babies which will be born. Hibakusha of children. But this damage is not formally proved yet. Now the second generation of Hibakusha children, F1, are now passing age 50s. 50s. 50. so bad. Head size. This boy carries small heads. This is medically called microcephaly. And the mental retardation took place. Another medical effect is psychological damage for science. In 1995, we studied about 7,000 survivors and found, using WHO General Health Questionnaire, we found short-distance survivors show very high psychological damage, depression and PTSD and so on. So this is a long-term psychological damage of survivors, first recognized by scientific method. For example, this is a lady who lost all seven members except her, among eight siblings. She suffered a very severe face burn. This face is look very well healed, but there is no normal skin. These are wounds. So she lost her chance of marriage, and she worked at University Hospital for until retirement. She recently died at my nursery home, and she suffered from gastric cancer too. So, in summary, the atomic bombs are gene-targeting weapon. The radiation immediately causes DNA damage that induces leukemia cancers during survivor's entire life. Psychological effect is also long-lasting and profound. From medical viewpoint, nuclear weapons are apparently anti-humanitarian in its nature. Together with its indiscriminate effects on human beings and devastating consequences on cities and the lack of medical aid, only a solution of this danger and fear is their total elimination. This is a slide which shows my talk at the first international conference on humanitarian impact of nuclear weapons, which was held in Oslo, Norway, March 4 to 5, 2013. The second, third conferences were held in Mexico and Austria, Vienna. Those conferences led the world opinion toward the inhumane nature of nuclear weapons, and it further grown into the present United Nations meeting to establish nuclear ban treaty in this year. Mr. Barack Obama inaugurated 2009, and he gave us a famous brave declaration. And he said, I promise a nuclear-free world in future. Mr. Obama visited Hiroshima. This is the first visit by the United States president, official. 2016, May 27. From President Obama's address, I would like to read. Science allows us to communicate across the seas and fly above the clouds. These are airplanes. To cure disease, medical development, and understand the cosmos. But those same discoveries can be turned into ever more efficient killing machines, weapons. Extreme weapons, nuclear weapons. The words of the modern age teach us this truth. Hiroshima teaches us this truth. Technological progress without an equivalent progress in human institutions can doom us. This sentence is a little bit difficult to understand. I'll later explain in the next slide. The scientific revolution that led to the splitting on atom divides, a moral revolution as well, a moral revolution. He emphasized this moral revolution as well at Hiroshima Peace Park. According to his talk, I understand that human being has the most developed brain among animal world. The brain created human culture on the earth. That is why we are prosperous on this globe. But human beings struggle wars and conflicts by using weapons. Human wisdom created philosophy and science. And also we have ethics and the humanity. So we seriously need a revolution in human wisdom to overcome ill-developed science, that it is nuclear weapons, by the moral revolution. Mr. Obama said, this moral revolution is very, very important. Your generation people, our hope. Maybe I was born in 1943 and lived whole course of the nuclear age, but maybe I will not see the end of this nuclear age. But your generation people. I'm confident. You are our hope to make the revolution your human wisdom. In the final part of my talk, I will introduce some interesting but serious simulation of 16 kiloton Hiroshima-sized bomb detonation on the real 1 million city, the present Hiroshima. Hiroshima scientists, including medical scientists, simulated 1 kiloton bombs on the surface of the Hiroshima, or 16 kiloton. And another simulation is 600 meter detonation of 16 kiloton bomb. This is Hiroshima size. And 1 megaton, the smallest hydrogen bomb, 1 megaton, 2,400 meter high. The same area as 1945 detonation was destroyed by 60 kiloton air blast. 60 kiloton surface and 1 kiloton surface explosion. Small area of Hiroshima city destroyed. But 1 megaton hydrogen bomb destroyed 18 kilometers. So Hiroshima city, not only Hiroshima city, but Kure city, the other cities are involved. And among 1 million people, about 700,000 people die. This is only one bomb, only one. If two countries exchange nuclear bombs, more than 50 or 100, you can imagine the devastation is tremendous. As a result of such a nuclear exchange, for example, the India-Pakistan war, if happens, or a US-Russia war, if 50 million tons were used, or a US-Russia war with new start arsenals, they have now new start arsenals. 150 million tons was used, the global temperature. Now we are facing a steep increase of within 1 degree centigrade warming of our globe. The temperature after such a local or global nuclear war, temperature quickly drops. This causes, of course, the devastation of major cities, but also our agriculture all over the globe. So global suffering takes place, and the nuclear winter will come, and no harvest time comes. That causes famine. 2 billion people will die due to this famine, lack of foods. So this is a photograph, Earth sun surrounded by smoke, cloudless sky at noon, 12 o'clock, after 100 atom bombs detonated in cities. Okay? Farmers are looking eyes wide. In the beginning of my talk, I said we simulated 60 kiloton bombs on Hiroshima, present Hiroshima. This is the Hiroshima. This was this video was made of NHK, Nihon Osotyokai, Japanese national broadcasting. And unfortunately, this video doesn't contain sounds. So please imagine the sound by yourself. The buildings are very strong, but 70 years ago, all Hiroshima houses were broken, but the tall buildings on modern cities can stand, keep standing, but glasses are broken. So you can easily imagine those people who are walking inside the buildings, they were severely injured. My keynote lecture ends now. Thank you for your attention.